Hey guys, it's Melanie. Happy Tuesday to everybody. Today I wanted to do a review of a hair product that I picked up at Target several days ago and that I have been trying to use in some different kinds of ways to see what works best. The product is the John Frieda Luxurious Volume Blowout Spray, and this is the box that it comes in. And so I have a little bit of a confession about this product. When I picked it up at Target, as many of you know, I'm trying to go cruelty-free with my cosmetics and body care and hair care products, at least for the remainder of this year, to really see what it's like to actually be cruelty-free. I am one of those people that I have not gotten rid of all of my other non-cruelty-free products, and I am choosing to buy from The Body Shop, even though The Body Shop is owned by L'Oreal. L'Oreal, as a company, does test on animals, but The Body Shop itself does not. So that's kind of how I am determining how I get my products is, even though, like, a company is under an umbrella company like L'Oreal or Estee Lauder, if the specific company itself does not test on animals, I will still purchase products from them. So that's just my kind of definition of how I'm choosing to go with it. I know that that offends some people because it's either an all or nothing kind of deal, but this is just what I'm doing. So when I pick this up, normally when I do, I'm trying to be more conscious of like checking the internet beforehand to make sure that I'm purchasing from a specifically cruelty-free company. But when I was at Target, I just grabbed it and kind of just spaced checking whether it was cruelty-free or not. So I have since done a little bit of research, and it seems that while John Frieda themselves don't test on animals, they are under the, it's KOA USA company. KAO USA. I believe that KAO does test on animals. And so I'm guessing that possibly some of the ingredients from this were tested on animals. So I'm not sure. So there's my confession about that. I probably fudged on that one, but I decided to go ahead and still use the product. So yeah, I think I may have failed on that one, but I will not be making that mistake again. So just wanted to kind of own up to that. You do get, back to talking about the product, you do get 4 ounces, and it comes in a spray bottle like this, so it's kind of a long, skinny bottle. And what it says is that it creates all-over natural fullness for the look of a salon-quality blowout. It transforms fine hair. So that's why I initially picked this up. I do have really fine, thin hair. As you can see, I don't really have, like, a ton of hair, which is why I keep it short. When I have long hair, it just looks straggly, and it just doesn't look very good. So I've given up on that dream. And I'm not the type to put in extensions, so it's just not happening for me. I'm not going to have luscious locks, at least in this lifetime. So anyway, the way that you use this is you spray through towel-dried hair, and you make sure that your hair is fully saturated with the product. Also, remember to spray it at your roots. Then you're supposed to comb through and to evenly distribute the product, and then you are supposed to use a blow dryer until completely dry. So, and then kind of finish style as usual, it says. So, the reason that I bought this was actually because I am trying to not necessarily blow dry my hair, but I want to be able to put some products in there that will still help to add a little bit of volume and a little bit of, oomph, I guess, at the roots, even if I don't take the time to fully blow dry my hair. My hair is, it's color treated, as you can probably imagine. The ends are pretty dry. I do need a haircut at this point. So I'm just trying to avoid maybe blow drying my hair at least 3 or 4 days out of the week. And the ingredients on here are kind of what made me want to try this, other than specifically it's for like fine hair. So this does have sea salt in it. It does have hydrolyzed wheat protein, and this also does have alcohol in it. So probably not the healthiest thing I could put in my hair, but I figured at least with the sea salt and the wheat protein that it would help just kind of beef my hair up a little bit when I didn't necessarily want to blow dry it. So I have used this a couple of different ways now. I have used it when I blow dried my hair, and it works great. So I used it by itself. Despite having sea salt and alcohol in it, it makes my hair crazy soft. I don't know why that would be happening, but my hair is like silky, like soft. As far as the volume that it provides, it's not quite as voluminous as I was hoping it would be, but it definitely helps to beef my hair up a little bit. So I will give it bonus points for that. I have used it in conjunction with my Rusk Thick Spray. I have used it in conjunction with my Tresemme 24-Hour Body Volumizing Mousse. And it works great with both of those products, and it works pretty great on its own. So today, for example, I sprayed it all over my hair when it was wet, and then I went through and I sprayed my Rusk Thick Spray, mostly in my root area, and then I just let my hair air dry. So this is absolutely no blow drying here. My hair is still, it's a lot thicker than if I were to just let it air dry with nothing in it at all. So it makes a difference, enough of a difference to where I feel okay not blow drying my hair. So my hair has been air drying now for probably about 2 hours since my shower. And it feels good. It feels really soft. It's very, like, there's no, like, tangles or, because of the sea salt, I was a tiny bit afraid that it would make my hair crunchy feeling. It's not crunchy at all. Like, it just feels really nice. And, I mean, this is obviously not glamorous hair. I'm not going for something, like, blowout looking by any means today. It's a pretty laid back day for me, so I'm not worried about looking super fancy, but I do like to have something in my hair because I do oftentimes have meetings in the evening with clients, and my hair can't look like a total hot mess, so this makes it at least look okay, and I can get away without blow drying it necessarily. So this has a really nice sprayer on it. It puts basically a fine mist over your hair, so you don't have to use a ton of it. I section off my hair and kind of mist an area, section off another area, mist, you know, both the top and underneath of my hair. And then I just take a comb, comb it through, and kind of fluff up my hair. And then I let it air dry from there, and it's been working well. So, As far as repurchasing this in the future, I'm going to do a little bit more research. I would definitely repurchase it if I could find out for sure whether John Frieda actually does test on animals or not. And, you know, I have quite a few subscribers who are cruelty-free and have shared a lot of information with me. So if you know, definitely let me know in a comment down below. If this is not cruelty-free, that's okay. I will just not buy it again. I will probably actually save this bottle, though, and I may put some of my other styling products in here because this just has such a nice sprayer on it, and it just did a really good job of evenly distributing the product in my hair. So this is definitely a nice bottle, so I'll keep it for maybe some other products that I can find. So yeah, overall, I mean, it was a good thing for me to try. You know, I wish that I would have probably done a little bit more research beforehand, but again, it was one of those moments, and this is probably just because I haven't been cruelty-free for very long. Like, sometimes you just don't think about it. When you're buying stuff, you're just like, oh, this looks like fun, and you put it in your cart, and then you go home, and you start using it, and then you're like, why didn't I think to, like, just Google it, like, while I was there? And I've been doing that with a lot of stuff. But this was just one of those times where I just didn't do it. So anyway, I wanted to own up to that because I said that I would, if I purchased items that weren't cruelty free. So anyway, let me know if you know for sure. But this gets two thumbs up. If you, you know, if you're not necessarily cruelty free and you're looking to try a new product and you have finer than hair, I would give this a whirl. It's really nice if you actually like round brush and blow dry your hair. It does make it like nice and big and voluminous. And it still makes it like crazy soft. I mean, it even says on here, visibly full, touchably soft hair. So I would absolutely agree with that. So anyway, I will let you know if this ends up leaving any kind of residue on my hair. So far, so good. But I shampoo my hair every day. So, and for those of you that are going to suggest not to wash my hair every single day, I have tried that. My hair is too oily. Like my skin just in general is very oily. I need to wash my hair every single day. I use a good shampoo. I use, you know, good like moisturizing conditioner. So I don't have the option to like skip a day. And I've tried lots of dry shampoos and it just doesn't work on my hair. So I am an everyday shampoo kind of girl, but back to this. Works great. Give it a try if you're interested. Let me know if you have any questions down below, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.